the ocean and is moving this away. If your soul's not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. There's a storm out on the ocean and is moving this whole way. If your soul's not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. There's a storm high on the ocean and is moving this away. If your soul not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. Drift away. Drift away. You will surely drift away. If your soul's not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. Drift away. You will surely drift away. If your soul's not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. On the ocean, oh, and it's moving this away. If your soul's not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. Drift away. You will surely drift away. If your soul's not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. One more time. Drift away. Drift away. You will surely drift away. If your soul's not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. In the Old Testament book of Job, chapter 42, verses 10 through 17. Job chapter 42, verses 10 through 17. Continue to put emphasis on family matters. Job chapter 42, I'm beginning with verse 10, and I will read down 17th verse. And the Lord turned the captivity of Job when he prayed for his friends. Also, the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had before. Then came there unto him all his brethren and all his sisters and all they that had been of his acquaintance before time, and did eat bread with him in his house. And they bemoaned him and comforted him over all the evil that the Lord had brought upon him. Every man also gave him a piece of money, and every one an earring of gold. So the Lord blessed the latter end of Job more than his beginning, for he had 14,000 sheep and 6,000 camels, and 1,000 yoke of oxen and 1,000 she asses. He had also 7 sons and 3 daughters. He called the name of the first Jemima, and the name of the second Kizia, and the name of the third Karen Happer. And in the land, in all the land, were no women found so fair as the daughters of Job. And their father gave them inheritance among their brethren. After this lived Job 140 years, and saw his sons and his sons' sons, even 4 generations. So Job died, being old and full of days. I want to talk about another look at the Job family. Another look at the Job family. Amen. Thank you, Ursula. This message today is a follow-up from last Sunday's message as we talked about a look at Job's family. Some of what we shared on last Sunday was how what's recorded about Job's family can be a help to our families. We talked about the piety that existed in his family, because last Sunday we talked about Job chapter 1, that Job was a perfect and upright man, one who feared God and eschewed evil. How Job lived a godly life on a daily basis. We talked about that even though everybody in the family is not living right, somebody ought to be living right. We also talked about the parenting in the family, because the Bible told us last Sunday that Job had 7 boys and 3 girls. And we talked about how God blessed his family to expand, how he was blessed to have 10 children. We talked about last Sunday how Job saw the need to have some children that would walk like him, look like him, grin like him, and even act like him. We talked about the possessions in the family, how God had blessed Job with much wealth. And we remember last Sunday we shared how the wealth that Job had, he didn't allow that to divide his family. We don't see them fighting over material things. And we talked about how material things should not divide the family. We also last Sunday, if you remember, talked about the protection that was provided for the family. Remember last Sunday in Job chapter 1, we talked about how God had put a hedge around the family. And we talked about how even the devil can't do you no harm unless he gets permission from God. The devil can't do everything he want to do because God got a hedge around our families. We also talked last Sunday, if you remember, about the problems in the family. We talked about even though Job was a perfect and upright man, even though he and his family was wealthy, they still had problems. Remember, we shared with you how problems is something that will show up in every family. There is no family in existence upon the face of the earth that is problem-free. Every family has problems. Am I right about it? And then we closed out by talking about the praise in the family. Remember last Sunday we talked about after Job had lost his children and lost all of his possessions, that he bowed his head and worshiped. And he said, blessed be the name of the Lord. We talked about how there ought to be some praises in the family. Today, as we ease through the doors of chapter 42 of the book of Job, this chapter gives us the rest of the story. This chapter informs us how Job outlived his trials. This chapter lets us know that he made it through, that God turned things for Job. We read in the verse 10, the A section says, and the Lord turned the captivity of Job. God does have the ability to turn things around. This is another way of saying that God reversed his fortunes. Yes, God took him again from being broke to being wealthy. God turned things in Job's life. God is a divine turner. My brothers and sisters, God specializes in turning. Yes, he can turn sinners into saints. He can turn lazy folk into working folk. Are y'all listening to me? He can turn hateful people into loving people. He can turn nobodies into somebody. God specializes in turning. He can turn a dead church into a live church. He can take your nightmare on Elm Street and turn it into a little house on the prairie, because God specializes in turning things. The text said God turned the captivity of Job. And there might be somebody in here this morning, I don't know what you're dealing with. I don't know how bad it has gotten. I don't know how heavy your load is. But the good news is there is somebody who specializes in turning things. God can turn it around. Well, as I look at this text, the question comes, how did Job get through this trying time? Well, as we read through the book of Job, as I look at it, I see, first of all, that Job was blessed to get through it because of his perspective, his outlook on life, what he viewed, his opinion of life. As we read through the book of Job, we see that Job made some memorable pronouncements. He made some often quoted declarations during his trying times. These are not just words he uttered, but this was his conviction. This is something that Job believed with all of his soul. Job made it because of the perspective that he had. Let me show you what I'm talking about. When he lost everything he had, and they asked him, Job, how do you feel about it? He said, naked came I out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return thither. He said, the Lord gave, and the Lord had taken away. Everything I had and everybody in my life, they didn't really belong to me in the first place. They belong to God, and he can give and he can take whenever he get ready. And therefore he said, blessed be the name of the Lord. In Job chapter 2, we see his perspective when his wife suggested that he curse God and die. Even though he had lost everything, he was now sick. He had boils all over his body. And she suggested that, why don't you just go on and curse God and end it? Listen to his perspective. He said, woman, you speak as a foolish woman speaking. He said, as good as God has been to us, can we not put up with some tough times? Yes, Job had the right perspective. He said, you got to have sense enough to know things won't just be good for you in life. You're going to have some low times. But you got to learn how to keep your eyes on God, even through the low times. Because God can come back and make times good for you again. Not only that, but in the 13th chapter of the book of Job, we see his perspective again. He said in the midst of what he was going through, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. Job said, I made it because I understood you got to trust God. No matter what goes on in your life, you got to keep your trust in God. Yes, then he said in Job 14, man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. Yeah, don't you need a falling out when you have trouble? You're going to have trouble. Yeah, you're sure if you're born, you're going to have trouble. Trouble is just a part of life. But not only that, in Job 23 and 10, he said, but he knoweth the way that I take. And when he had tried me, I shall come forth as gold. Yeah, Job said, I know this is just a trying time for me. God is putting me to the test. But oh, when he gets through me, when he brings me through, I'm going to shine like pure gold. He had the right perspective. Amen. But not only that, yes, look at it. The Bible talks about how some of his friends came to see him, and they accused Job of being a hypocrite. And listen, let me tell you something. Job stood his ground. See, you don't have to be what folks say you are. Are y'all listening to me? Sometimes even your friends can have the wrong perspective and the wrong outlook and have the wrong judgment concerning you. Yeah, you're not what everybody say you are. Are y'all listening to me? Yes, you know, sometimes If UPS bring me something that I didn't order, I don't sign for it. And you can't sign for everything the devil bring to you. If somebody tell you you'll never amount to anything, don't you sign for that. Are y'all praying with me? Yes, and so Job stood his ground. But then secondly, I see his patience. He made it through his trial because he had patience. Job said, all the days of my appointed time, I'm going to wait till my change comes. Yes, the Bible in James 5 and 11 talks about the patience of Job. When things are not going right in your life, you got to trust and wait on God. You can't make things hurry up and change. You just got to wait on him. Yes, we often quote Isaiah 40, and many times we bypass the other verses and hurry up and quote verse 31 where it said, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. But really, you can't get the essence of that verse if you don't read verse 28. When he said, hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is he weary? There is no searching of his understanding. The next verse said, he giveth power to the faint. And to them that have no might, he increases strength. And he said, if you trust in people, he said, even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Yes, if you wait on God, he'll make your waiting worthwhile. Yes, Job waited. He waited on God, and God got him through. See, you can't write God off because you're having trouble. You can't give up on God. Don't take your name off of the waiting list. You keep waiting on God. Well, thirdly, the text says in Job 42 that he made it through because he prayed. Did you notice the verse? The verse said, God turned things for Job when he prayed for his friend. When he prayed for his buddies who had accused him of being a pretender. When he prayed for his friends who accused him of being a hypocrite. God turned things for Job when he prayed for his false accusers. Are y'all listening to me? I'm glad the Bible says God turned it when he prayed, because it reminds us that prayer still works. I'm glad the Bible says when he prayed, because prayer still changes things. Prayer accesses miracles from God. Prayer is the way to a breakthrough. There's power in prayer. He prayed for his friend. You can't be cold to the folk who do you wrong. Yes, you can't be cold for giving them a hard time, but God got a way of bringing them back around to you. And the right thing to do is to pray for them. Yes, the Bible says he prayed for his friends. He prayed that God would forgive them, that God would not enter into judgment upon them. Yes, because God had told them, say, y'all need to go and apologize to Job. And you need to offer up to me a burnt offering. And if you don't do it, I'm going to deal with you after you follow. So these same folk who have falsely accused Job had to come back to him and say, Job, we were wrong about you and God. We understand that we were out of line, and would you please forgive us and pray for us? And the Bible said, and Job prayed for them. Yes, brothers and sisters, you can't make it through your trials holding grudges against somebody. You can't expect God to turn things for you when you're still mad at folk. When you're bitter with people, when you don't like somebody, talking about they make you sick, they get on your last nerve. You got to have a right spirit. Yes, sir. He prayed. But then we see that he had another motivation to live because of his people. This verse tells us about some more of his people who showed up in his life. Now notice now, after God turned things around, he had some relatives to come see him. Look at the verse. The verse says, then came unto Job his brothers and his sisters and all of his acquaintance before. Now listen, the reason why the verse said then they showed up is because when he was going through, they were nowhere to be found. But after God turned things around, here they come. Are y'all listening to me? All of us have some fair weather family members. Amen. Long as things are fine, they're with you. But when the going gets tough, they're gone. Yes, I call them fair weather family. Yes, they're there with you long as you got your own car. They don't mind hanging out with you long as you got your own money. But when you get broke, they're hard to get a hold to. Y'all not listening to me. Yeah, fair weather families, and I don't know, you got them. You can sit there and look at me like that, but you got them. You know who they are. Some of you might be some of those families. Looking at me like that. Some of y'all might be those fair weather family members. Are y'all listening to me? No wonder the verse said, then came his brothers and his sisters. Nowhere to be found when he was going through. Nowhere to be found when he was sick. Nowhere to be found when he was broke. But soon as God turned things, here they come. Are y'all listening to me? Well, the question comes, why they show up now? Yeah, why they show up now? Why? Look at what the verse says. The verse says, first of all, they came to consume some food. Look at the verse if you think I'm lying. The verse said, and did eat bread with him in his house. Y'all, they didn't bring no groceries, but they came to help eat up. They showed up to help eat up some food. Are y'all listening to me? Got to give Job his props here, because some of us would not have handled that so well. You know what I'm saying? If we don't say it out loud to them, we go behind the back and we call some of them, but you see them? Ain't lifted a finger to come see about me when I was going through, and then soon as things done passed and I'm having a little get together, here they come to eat up all my stuff. I wish they'd go back to the house. They didn't have that kind of spirit. Are you listening to me? Look at the text. Job did not act cold toward them. Amen. He didn't say to them, why y'all show up now? You know, why y'all come? Y'all ain't coming in and eat up all my groceries. He didn't act that way. He welcomed them. He was glad to see them. upon them. How can you be glad to see folk who got your same blood, who was not there for you when you were going through? I hear Job saying, man, I'm just so glad that God got me through that. I ain't got time to be mad at nobody. I'm just glad that I'm still here, got a reasonable portion of health and strength. I'm in my right mind, and I'm glad to see my folks. Amen. Look here, God been too good to me. I ain't mad at him. I know they didn't come see me, but I ain't mad at him. As a matter of fact, if they had come to see me, they couldn't do nothing for me. Nobody could turn my situation but God. So I ain't mad at him. That's why I tell you, if you have to go to the hospital sometime, or if you get sick and everything, I think one of the biggest problems and mistakes a lot of people make is, you know, when they've been sick and dying, they talk about, well, y'all didn't come see me. Nobody called me. Well, half the time, we didn't know it. I mean, only God is omniscient. We're not all known. You have to let somebody know something. But then on the other hand, if we did know and didn't come see you, and God blessed you to get up, you got time to be upset with somebody. You ought to be glad that you're here, that you're alive and well, and we haven't had your funeral yet. Are y'all listening to me? Do you think you're still alive because you've been so good? You think you're still alive because they gave you the right medicine? No, the only reason why you're still here is because God is keeping you alive. There's a lot of folk younger than you been dead. Are y'all listening to me? Yeah, so he's not mad. Y'all help yourself. Y'all help yourself. Come on, let's celebrate. Let's celebrate. Praise the Lord. He'll get you some more pork chops. We'll celebrate. Hey, cuz, come get some green, man. Get all the green you want. Help yourself. Fix you some plates to go. I'm just glad to see y'all. I was down, but he got me up. At one point, I smelled so bad because of my sickness, nobody wanted to be around me. But hey, he's healed me. I'm smelling good now. I'm feeling good. I'm glad y'all want to be around me. Listen, you can't write your folk off because of their shortcomings. Because truth of the matter is, we all have some shortcomings. Are you listening to me? None of us are perfect. We all got something about us that need fixing. And listen, this text helped me. You can't change folk. You can't make even your family members be what you think they ought to be. But they're still family. Oh, you listening to me? We got to love them anyhow. Treat them right anyway. Yeah. Y'all come on and eat. Welcome. Hey, sister. Hey, bro. Come on in, boy. I'm sorry. I got mad. Shut up. Come on in here, sit down. God been good to me. The goodness of God is greater than your neglecting to come see me. Yeah. I ain't got time to be keeping up with all of that. I ain't got time to be thinking about how many times you didn't call me, how many times you didn't think about, I don't care. God been good to me. And his goodness outweighs all the other stuff. That's not all. Look at what the verse says. They didn't just come to eat. The verse said they came to comfort him. They came, look here, man. Look at it, man. You really helped us. You showed us something. We're glad that you made it through, and we want you to know that we love you. We're still here for you. And just want to encourage you. We know God is with you. They came to comfort him. said, look. Now some people say, well, how can they comfort him? Well, they could not have come at all. Oh, y'all listen to me. They did come. And he was glad to see him because at one while, because of his condition, nobody wanted to be around him. But they came, how comforting it was for them to want to be around him now. I'm glad that in spite of all I've been through, folks still want to be around me. I got to hurry up and get through, but there's some folk who knew me before I got saved. Are you listening to me? There's some folk who knew me when I was outside of God's will. And what they saw and knew about me, they didn't want to be around me. They couldn't stand me. Some of them couldn't stand me. But now that I've been changed, I'm glad when they want to be around me. Because God has fixed it. Where the folk who used to didn't want to have anything to do with me, want to have something to do with me now. And I wonder if there's anybody in here that can testify. There was a time, there were some people in your life, you got on their last nerve. They didn't like the way you were living. They didn't like the way you were going. They didn't like the folk you were hanging out with. They didn't like some of your ways, some of your deeds. But since God has gotten in, now they see you in a different way. They came to comfort him. But that's not all. The text said they also came to contribute to him. They didn't come broke. They came and gave him some money. Now, you can't miss this. Job was no longer hurting. But yet they still gave him some money. It was a custom in that day and time. If a person had made it through a trying time, people would come and give them some money just to let them know, look here, we support you and all that you've been through, and we're glad that God got you through it. They gave him some money. They contributed to him some money. And oh, my brothers and my sisters, thank God for Job's family. Even though he had been through a lot, even though they failed to do some things, they have now come through to show their support. And I stop by to tell you, whatever support you get from your family, you ought to appreciate the support that they give you. Am I right about it? And so the Bible says that they came. And as a result, the Lord blessed the latter end of Job more than his beginning. The Bible said God gave him 14,000 sheep, 6,000 camels, 1,000 yoke of oxen, and 1,000 donkeys. God again gave him 7 sons and 3 daughters. And the Bible says, and he named the firstborn daughter Jemima. And her name means daylight. Meaning that my night of suffering has passed and my daylight of blessing has come. In other words, he said, God has already turned my midnight into day. And so I'm going to name this girl Jemima. His second daughter he named Kizia. And her name means a herb of pleasant fragrance. He said, when I had those boils, I had an odor that nobody wanted to be around. But now since God has healed me, I smell good now. And so I'm gonna name her Kizia. And then my third girl, he said, I'm gonna name her Karen Hapaka, which means plenty is restored. Because God has taken my life even when I was broke. And he's given back to me more than I have ever had. Anybody here today know that God can give you more than you have ever had? God specializes in taking nothing and turning it into something. Am I right about it? And so the Bible says, after this, Job lived. Yes, I'm glad the Bible said after Job had been through all that he had gone through, he was able to live. Yeah, now the Bible says Job lived after his trials 140 years. Yes, which makes us believe that when Job first started having his trials, he was around 70 years old. And since God gave him twice as much as he had before, God let him live an extra 140 years. Am I right about it? Anybody here know God got ways of making your life last longer? Yes, he lived long enough not only to see his children, but he lived to see his grandchildren. He didn't just live to see his grandchildren, but he lived to see his great-grandchildren. He didn't just live to see his great-grandchildren, but he even saw his great-great-grandchildren. And some believe, yes, he even lived to see his great-great-great-great-grandchildren. Yes, anybody here know that God can give you more time than you thought you would get? Yes, you can ask God to give you a day. He's so good, he'll give you a whole week. You can ask God to give you a whole week. He's so good, he'll give you a whole month. You can ask God to give you a whole month, and he'll give you a whole year. Yeah, you can ask God to let you live to see your children get grown. And if you don't watch it, you'll be around long enough to see the grandchildren get grown. Hey, God, all right, he'll give you more than what you asked for. Am I right about it? I'm clothing when I tell you, brothers and sisters, I'm glad today the Bible said, after this, Job lived. I come to tell somebody, whatever's going on in your life, if you keep your hand in God's hand, after this, you can live. Yes, after cancer, you can live. After a heart attack, you can live. After lupus, you can live. Whatever your trouble is, you can live. After divorce, you can live. After friends walk away from you, you can live. The Bible said, after this, Job lived. Ain't God all right? And I'm wondering here, is there anybody know there's a blessing in living? Did you hear me? As I look through the scriptures, I see a lot of folk who went through a lot, but when it was all said and done, they lived. Noah and his family went through the worst storm you could have in history, but when the storm was over, they lived. Am I right about it? Samson had a fight with a lion. Am I right about it? But after he fought with the lion, he lived. Yes, David fought with a giant named Goliath. But after the fight, David lived. Ain't God all right? The Hebrew boys were thrown in a burning fiery furnace. But after the furnace, they lived. Daniel was put in a den of hungry lions. But on the next morning, he lived. Ain't God all right? Paul Saul went through a whole lot. Did you hear me? He was trapped in Damascus. But after Damascus, he lived. He was in a shipwreck in Acts 27. But after the shipwreck, he lived. Yes, he was stoned in Lystra. But after he was stoned, he got up and lived. He was bitten by a snake in Acts 28, but after the snake bite, he lived. Ain't God all right? Jesus went through a lot, but he lived. Am I right about it? He said, birds have nests, foxes have holes, but the Son of Man have nowhere to lay his head. But he still lived. Everything he had belonged to somebody else. He was born in another man's stable. He grew up in another man's house. He preached from another man's boat. He borrowed another man's lunch. But he still lived. He was betrayed by Judas, but he still lived. He was denied by Peter, but he still lived. He was beaten by the Roman soldiers, but he still lived. He was nailed to a whole rugged cross. They hung him high, stretched him wide. He died, then they died. They put him down in a borrowed tomb. But after the third day morning, he rose. Lived. Anybody here know he lives? And oh, I'm so glad, in spite of all I've been through, I thank God I'm still here. Anybody here know you've been through a lot, but you thank God that you're still here? I thank God I'm still alive. Yes, I could have been dead, sleeping in my grave, but oh yeah, I'm still here. Thank you, Jesus, I'm still here. Yeah, oh yeah. Still here, still here, still here. The devil tried to take us out, but we're still here. Folk dug ditches for us, but we're still here. We had some losses, but we're still here. Lost some loved ones, but we're still here. We've been down, but we're still here. Things have gotten bad, but we're still here. Load got heavy, but we're still here. Had to cry sometime, but we're still here. Still here, still here. Oh! Yeah! Yeah! Oh, yeah! Still here, still here, still here. Glad I'm still here. Anybody here, no matter what's going on, you may have arthritis, but you're still here. May not be kicking high, but if you're kicking at all, you're still here. Ain't God good? Yeah!